Hello there. In this video, you will learn how to choose an appropriate step size when you implement Euler's method. Here we have a general differential equation. The derivative of y is equal to a function f of t and y. We will approximate the solution with a numerical method, with Euler's method. Time is discretized in a step size of delta t. So we will not calculate the values of y at for all times, as could be done with an analytical method. We estimate y only at multiples of delta t. We start with the initial condition and use the formula for n equal to 0 to approximate the value of y at time delta t. Then we can use the same formula for n equal to 1 to approximate the value of y at time 2 times delta t, and so on, until we have covered the time span that we are interested in. We want to estimate the number of rainbow fish in our aquarium after a few months. We start with 30 fish, and the mathematical model for the population size is this differential equation. The growth term is bounded, and we have seen that the equilibrium value of approximately 720 fish is stable. When you compare the differential equation for the rainbow fish with the general one, you see that our function f is now a function of t and p, and that f equals the right-hand side of the differential equation. To apply Euler's method, we also need a step size, delta t. Now we are going to experiment to see what is an appropriate step size. First, we try a step size of a week. Delta t equals 7 days. We start at time 0 with 30 rainbow fish. With the differential equation, we calculate the derivative. dp dt equals 0.7 times p times etc. etc. So when you substitute p equal to 30, dp dt becomes 0.16. This means that the line tangent to the solution curve of p has a slope of 0.16. To be precise, the slope also has a unit. It is 0.16 per day. Now we estimate the value of p after a week as the old p plus the step size times the derivative. So p7 is approximated by 30 plus 7 times 0.16, which equals 31.1. And then we calculate the derivative at t equal to 0 by substituting p equals 31.1 in the formula for the derivative. Now the derivative is 0.88 per day. The tangent line is still almost flat. Now we can estimate the value of p at t equal to 14. After 2 weeks, p is estimated as 37.3 fish. Another derivative, the slope is increasing a little. P after 3 weeks becomes 70.9. The slope is rapidly increasing. It is now 24.9 per day. And then P rises to 245. The slope becomes very steep. P becomes 914 fish and, oops, the slope is negative all of a sudden. The reason for that is that a P of 914 fish is way over the equilibrium value of approximately 720 fish. The equilibrium is stable, so when P is larger, the derivative is negative. P should return to its equilibrium value. However, the next step shoots again through the equilibrium value, and the whole population size becomes negative. So this is nonsense, of course. So with this step size of 7 days, the numerical solution is clearly not valid after the fourth step. We will have to try a smaller step size. So the results for a step size of 7 were not okay. Let us now try a DT of 4 days. We start again for t equal to 0 with 30 rainbow fish. Now, with the smaller step size, the value of p, starts to increase a little earlier. But, uh-oh, it shoots through the equilibrium value again, becomes reasonable again, but the step size of 4 days is too large. And the numerical solution is still erratic. Let's again halve the step size. Now take dt 2 days. 5 steps at once. And yes, only a little bit through the equilibrium value. The solution is still rather angular around 20 days. So now a step size of just 1 day. And after 10 iterations, and then 20 days, and after that, the population gets into its equilibrium state. So now you have seen that for our problem, step sizes that are larger than a day are clearly too large. The question is now, is the step size of 1 day small enough, or should we refine further? Luckily, this rainbow fish calculation is so tiny that even for a very small step size, your computer will do the calculation in a wink, and the results can be stored in a few kilobytes. Only when you use a very, very, very small step size, you will run into problems because of the machine precision. Your computer only calculates with a finite number of digits. So, you could use a step size much smaller than a day. The question remains, why should you? What is an appropriate step size for our rainbow fish problem? We have approximated the solutions of the differential equation for the rainbow fish population with Euler's method. Step sizes that are larger than a day give obviously wrong results. How much smaller than a day is appropriate? You have to think of how accurate do you want the results to be? What was the problem we were trying to solve? Is it useful to calculate up to 0.001 fish? And you also have to consider the accuracy of the model. How precise is the differential equation that we derived? In the assignments that follow this video, you will simulate the results and explore these questions yourself.